again to how season one finished. The Drop Bears, it felt, you know, we're talking about in the space of like less than a month probably between the end of regular season and through to finals, they went from losing 4-0 to Mastermind to being the top team in the region. Yeah. You know what I mean? So there's a lot of growth to be made. A lot of these players across all of the teams very talented. It's just about, you know, finding that that gel together, I suppose, as a team, as six players competing together.
Yeah, good to see Quats back in the lineup here for the Drop Bears. It's a mirror match as the first fight does begin. Jordacian gets the better of Yui on the Widowmaker, and well, that's pretty much the fight over already, especially considering Kalahex has just shut down two. You should get Kazette there, but doesn't quite land the shot. Still, it doesn't matter. The fight's over. Sydney Drop Bears, easy wipe.
Certainly is looking strong. Once again, Kalahex
65% already.
Farah. No surprises. Precisely what one might anticipate will occur. But it's how Dignity steps up to the challenge, Jordan, because it is quite a big challenge.
Probably it is indeed. Look, I mean, I think it's going to have to be, obviously, Yui is going to have to win some of these aim battles against Jordacian. I don't know if anyone's going to be able to deal with Kalahex in the form that he's in right now, but that's really on to Render and obviously Mini. That's a good start to the fight. Yui getting rid of Jordacian, that really gives the opening over to Dignity here, but they need to take advantage of it.
They certainly do. They need to find some room here and potentially get themselves back onto the point. But Yui now going to go down to Kalahex.
It's a big play from Kalahex. Oh, that's a massive air shot. Oh my god, Render absolutely demolished Kalahex. That is a sniper and a half. And now he's got Rocket Barrage available to him as well. Dignity all clumped up on the point. I don't think this is going to go too well, Ben.
No, you can find yourselves in a bit of trouble using the barrage in such a confined space. But Kalahex does manage to do it without really anything happening to him. Just finding the mech there of Mini, who's very quickly dealt with once that juicy, soft inside is revealed. it's like eating a crab.
It's like a caramel koala.
Well, yeah.
Caramello koala, goodness.
That's it.
Yui is actually getting the better of Jordacian in most of these Widowmaker battles, so I think what Dignity really needs to do here is just sort of slow things down a little bit, see if they can keep getting those advantages courtesy of Yui, but did someone just get booped off there? Doesn't look like it. I thought someone might have. Oh, well, there almost goes another one. Very, very dangerous territory when you're a Zenyatta standing on that bridge.
It is, look at this. And the battle just on the back of the Primal Rage, Jordan, Pizza is going to get knocked out, knocked off, destroyed there by Quats. And the rest of the team can't even push through for another 15 seconds purely because they're dealing with one giant Winston in their face.
Yeah. Yui's still getting those aim battle wins against Jordacian. He's now 3-1 up. But unfortunately for Dignity, they just don't have enough to deal with the rest of the players on Sydney Drop Bears, who might as well be playing 5 versus 6 at the moment because Jordacian's been dead most of these fights. But Kalahex is just doing so much work on that Farah. He's almost up to the Rocket Barrage again.
Has he died? If he's died, I don't think he's died once. If he has.
He'll probably go down here or he'll just have to back out. There we go. He does eventually get dropped. So Dignity, finally, the power of numbers does net themselves a cap, but it's only at 99% there for Sydney Drop Bears. So Dignity haven't really been able to do a lot of work here just yet. Now they're on the defense though. Yui, if he can get those picks early on, that's going to be a little bit more impactful than I think when Dignity's on the attack, where they still have to kind of push into the setup that the Drop Bears are running. Maybe Dignity have a chance of getting this one to be close, but I still have a lot of faith that the Drop Bears are going to be able to cap this one back. They have so much time to play with, Ben, and Kalahex is having a phenomenal game already. So,
there's very little to indicate that Dignity will be able to hold this out for the full 99%. But you'll be finding Kalahex to start things off. Obviously, the Infrasite making life that little bit easier here on the Widowmaker. And Mini, as you can see, does have that self-destruct available. Whether that's going to be used to hold into the point to zone, we will have to wait and see. But it's 2 apiece right now for Ultimate's Pizza, about to hit that Primal Rage as well. So potential for this fight to go the way of Dignity. We'll just have to see whether the Drop Bears can outplay them with that slight ultimate disadvantage that they have right now. But the time is ticking away. They're going to push on to the point and do so. To be fair, they're not looking too bad right here. Kalahex stays alive, finds Pizza. Render's gone down as well. You'd think that the Mercy is soon going to be picked up. You can see the self-destruct comes through. Are we going to find anyone? No, just keeps them off the point for now. Up to 65%, still 35 to go here for Dignity to bring this out to 99-99. But one by one, they appear to be going down here, Jordan. The Drop Bears will recapture the point. and then one would expect we'll be able to hold it through to the full 100%.
Yeah, I don't think anyone's going to be able to contest that one for Dignity. It looked too easy, really, for Sydney Drop Bears, didn't it? It was some nice teamwork, nice coordination between Color Hex and a Kraken. And as soon as Color Hex throws out that rocket barrage, you see Transcendence comes out from a Kraken. And it just appeared to be enough for Sydney Drop Bears to get the better of Dignity. Now, to be honest, I thought that it was going to be a little bit more difficult from that. Needed to see the Umbrella up maybe from Mini, the counter Transcendence out from Dignity as well, but it just really wasn't there. It wasn't the right timing. And I think that just goes to show the experience and the firepower advantage that the Sydney Drop Bears have here, where they can get so much out of so little. And Dignity, they have the same or even more ultimates available to them, but they still can't
and
hold on to the point.
It wasn't difficult.
No.
They essentially forced their way onto the point. Mm. Dignity dropped back to the other side of the same room. And from there, essentially the Drop Bears had free reign. They got the picks they needed. They lost like one hero in that fight.
Ooh, look at this.
That was it. Oh, going
Let's
on
see
a bit
what
of a scenic
is do.
Tour.
Not spotting too much out just yet.
It's a slow process moving around. They're not fast jets, are they? Let's be real.
No, definitely not. Well, you can go up and down pretty quickly, but not side to side. And Render gets the first pick onto a Kraken, a pretty big one considering now both the healers are actually dead for Sydney Drop Bears.
Yeah, that's going to make life just that little bit tougher, but no one is dealing with Color Hex. Yui is finding the kills for now. We'll continue to try and push through.
Oh, hi, Mini.
Yeah,
well,
Mini, she's going to get picked up there by Color Hex.
So Dignity, they got the two picks onto the two healers straight off the bat. But then basically, what, two DPS and a tank for Sydney Drop Bears? Essentially three versus six is Dignity there.
Yeah, again, no one dealing with the Pharah.
Jordation as well going nuts on the Widow. Like, it wasn't just Color Hex on Pharah. Of course, he did a lot of work there, up to 64%. He got two or three kills. But he also draws enough of the fire that Jordation has an easy time getting some picks. And Dignity, well, they needed to be able to cap that one out. And now, if you're going to continue to play like this...
But they're just running across the front. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know that there's going to be a Widow.
Yeah, I mean, especially as a Zenyatta, right? You can't be doing that as a Zenyatta.
Yeah.
Because that's like prime target number one. Absolutely no mobility at all.
And now, Jordation with the Infrasight, with a clear line of sight through to the spawn as well.
I don't know why you're taking that peek.
Yeah, we're not even, it doesn't even feel like we're playing a game right this second. So, certainly not a balanced one at least. So, this time around, a little bit less ideal for Dignity. They're going to need to find their way out of where they are. They're certainly stuck in the corner here, Jordan.
They're just being spawn camped by Jordation solo. Like, no one else on Sydney Drop Bears is doing anything. They're just sitting there to back him up, make sure that no one could dive on top of him. But literally, this is Jordation holding the entirety of Dignity in their spawn. One by one, they're getting picked off. They're taking silly peeks. They're like, okay, where's the Widowmaker? Let me look. Oh, I'm dead. Well, that's exactly what's going to happen when you're going up against a Widowmaker of this caliber.
All right. We've made it through, Jordan. I think it's time for an actual fight once again. Looks like they're going to come around behind Jordation here, but not dealing with him, which still allows him. He puts him in perfect position once again.
They don't actually know exactly where he is, and once they get past Jordation, then they have to run into the rocket barrage of Color Hex, so it's really neither here nor there. It's rock and a hard place, really, for Dignity.
Yeah.
They just can't get anything done here at all, Ben.
No, very tough battle here for Dignity. The Drop Bears certainly getting the better of them once again, looking very clean, very concise. And to be fair, they're not really having to do much at all.
And now they don't have the time to run around and get picked off. Jordation's going to play so aggressively here on the Widowmaker, and he gets Render. Before the fight even starts, Render's got himself a Dragon Blade. Someone's disconnected for Dignity. I mean, it's just absolutely nothing's going right for Dignity at the moment. Sydney Drop Bears, this is probably the cleanest wipe I've ever seen in a King of the Hill game in Contenders AU.
Yeah, I was going to say, it feels to me like that's how my matches turn out when I'm having a bad night and losing 100 SR in an hour. So, congratulations to the Drop Bears. Going to pick that one up 2-0 on Li Zhang Tao. Control point going across to them, doing so very quickly. Couldn't have gone... Look, before the first round, it was a little bit better.
I guess it could have gone slightly faster.
Round
but,
two.
Realistically speaking, you know, we saw last week, I think we were talking about when Drop Bears went up against the Tainted Mind. They essentially had like the fastest game in Contenders AU. Now, again, we're kind of on the same sort of a trajectory.
Yeah.
Obviously, it took me a little while to get that out, but
the
fact of the matter is, like, these teams are not...
It's Monday afternoon.
Yeah. These teams just, they can't seem to stand up against the Drop Bears when they have that coordination. And the firepower, I think, is really the big thing here for Drop Bears. You know, like, last season, they looked pretty good. Billa was in there, the Sombra meta. It worked pretty nicely for them. But now that Sombra meta is not a thing. Color Hex comes into this roster, and he just adds such a dynamic addition, I suppose, to the DPS roster in that he can play Pharah exceptionally, complements the hero pool that Jordacian has got as well. And it's just such a scary DPS duo here for the Drop Bears. Like, you could have basically... I mean, I don't want to say you could have put anyone in the tanks and the support situation there, but realistically, you look at that round and you just think, these guys didn't even have to work hard. Like, it was just Jordacian and Colorhex.
Yep.
Sitting there, Jordacian spawn camping for 50% of the cap time there, and the tanks are just sitting next to him going, well, look, if anyone dives in on you, we've got your back. But right now, we're just kind of having a relaxing game.
It's a bit weird, isn't it? And I guess it's one of those things, again, where we talk about where the work that the supports and the tanks do, when they do it well, makes the life of the DPS that much easier.
That's it, right?
They can almost show off.
It's like, you can look at a game and be like, okay, the DPS are absolutely popping off, but it's not really as easy to see sometimes the space that's being created by the tanks and the heals that are being put out by the supports and that kind of thing. So obviously it's a whole unit, but then really that's where the DPS then start to shine, which is absolutely the case here for the Drop Bears.
Yeah. Look, Jordan, all I'm going to say about this is that right now I am very concerned for whoever has to go up against them in playoffs, in semis.
Whoever's in fourth place in Group B, not a place you want to be.
That is not, you do not want to be there. If you're in Group B right now, you probably want third. Look, fourth will be okay. Fourth definitely better than fifth, but not by much at this point.
The scariest thing as well for Dignity here, and I guess for other teams just going forward, is that right now we've seen Jordacian just going crazy on Widow, and he's not even their like main Widowmaker player. The only reason that he was playing Widow there is because Colorhex is playing Pharah. Jordacian doesn't play Pharah, so if Colorhex is playing Pharah and they want to have a Widow, then it needs to be Jordacian. But if we're going to see the Widow Hanzo come out, well, that means Jordacian gets to move on to his best hero, which is Hanzo, and we also get to see Colorhex, an upgrade as far as most people are concerned, as far as the Widowmaker is, going on to the Widowmaker. So we've got an upgrade on the Widowmaker, then we've got Jordacian moving on to his best hero, and already that kind of a destruction.
There's no counter, right? Like, gave up on the... I think, maybe a lot of the difference here is that there was no Widow the second time around to counter. He essentially just could do what he felt like doing. So let's leave Liu Zhongtao in the past. We're going to Eichenwald now. It's our hybrid map. This one's going to be picked by Destiny. I suspect the vast majority of maps in this first match will be picked by them.
Yep.
And look, if this is Drop Bears on defense first, potential for a relatively quick round. What we're playing for here, Jordan, is that our four top teams at the end of the season will take four teams from each group through to playoffs. So that's top eight teams total. They'll play each other. And then from there, the top four teams are going to the Melbourne Esports Open. They're going to play in Rod Laver Arena. If you're an Australian, you'd probably know the name of that arena. They play the Australian Open Tennis there. It's absolutely massive. And the best thing is that you'll be able to buy tickets. You can buy tickets now. Secure your spot. Go down there and watch the top four teams. I don't know. I would bet all of my whatevers in the world that
esports dollars
that Drop Bears are going to be there, but I don't bet. But
pretty much are going to be there.
That's it, right? So that's one team that we know is locked in. So if you're a Drop Bears fan,
well, not quite locked in, but
they're locked in.
I get what you
mean. I'm going to say it now. Locked. They're locked. Jordan.
They might as well be. They really might as well.
They're locked.
Okay, so it's going to be Drop Bears starting off on defense. We've got Jordacian onto Hanzo. No Widowmaker this time. Colorhex is having a good time on Pharah. I see no real reason why he should switch at this point. Dignity aren't going to have an easy time of dealing with him because you can't really run a Widow on attack here quite so easily. And then if you're swapping off onto like a McCree or a Soldier, then that's sort of also really not so ideal. So it's going to come down to if Render can have more of an impact than Colorhex can on this Pharah, but I really don't know if that's going to be a likely chance.
Look at Jordacian up in amongst the buildings.
Yeah, a bit over-eager there.
Yeah, just a little bit, right? After
no respect.
A great game number one. Be very easy to get baited into thinking.
He's been bailed out by Colorhex. Like, Colorhex just hits two fantastic air shots onto Render, and it's like, well, I've just fixed your mistake.
Yui in here with the Tracer from behind, trying to do work, but we'll see whether it's successful or not. Dio's gone down to Colorhex again.
Oh, Colorhex,
man.
Oh.
Just time and time again, Prince is going to go down here as well.
I don't know what to say, Ben. Colorhex is just absolutely owning Dignity right now.
Finally, he goes down, but
it's too late. It's too late.
Yeah. Someone's got to do something about the Pharah. And if they're not doing something about the Pharah, then they have to do something about Jordacian. When they do something about Jordacian, then Colorhex is there to clean it up and vice versa.
Well, Jordacian wasn't even in that fight at all. Like, he was on the way back from spawn, and Colorhex has really just done enough damage for the two of them anyway. Relation's going to go down early again. He's really not having a good time here. Kal-Hex, on Ikevold.
Where are you? Save the day.
This time it's Quats and Shayo.
Look, Yui's found two pretty big picks here, to be perfectly honest. It's a great start.
Sure.
Pulse Bomb is available. Kal-Hex is here, but it doesn't matter.
But the finish is there for the Drop Bears.
Yep.
The tank line is just doing too much work for Drop Bears. Kal-Hex is doing too much work. And it's just the single healer. So Belloc going down there, you know, you would have thought, okay, that's probably going to be a real big problem for Drop Bears, but it's not really. At the end of the day, when Sydney Drop Bears are able to just frag out, even when they're on low HP.
Yeah, Drop Bears looking real comfortable here with triple tank.
Yui's going to be cooked in a second.
Seems to be doing the work, getting the picks and not even needing to use the Hulk to get them half the time, Jordan.
Kal-Hex is down, right? So now it's time for Jordation to sit up.
Self-destruct comes through. Going to find two, both Render and Dio. That's that AA we talk about, Jordan. If you don't have AA, use an ultimate.
Yeah. This is not looking fun at all for Dignity. I'm not really sure what else I can say about this one. Look, Minnie's even
Minnie's
being...
like just trying to get out so she can jump off.
Oh, this is really just mean.
This is some cyberbullying.
Look
right
at all
now.
This. Oh, that's embarrassing. A Kraken.
Yeah.
It'll happen though.
Okay, no one saw it.
Happens to me, but then again, I'm plat, so.
90 seconds on the clock, Jordan, and we have three ultimates ready to go for the Drop Bears. Three ready to go for Dignity.
Ben, I don't think it matters.
Look, for their sake, I hope they can do something with them. That's all I'm going to say, because hasn't been great. They've definitely been struggling up against this setup. For whatever reason, no match. You could say no match for the triple tank, but that's not really what the case is. It's just no match for the Drop Bears in general.
Yeah.
So
I don't think it matters what Drop Bears run here, but we do see those ultimates being put to good use by Dignity. Burtlog is down. That's a really, really big pick early on in the piece. And now Dignity just have to ensure that they don't throw this one away because they have a two-player advantage. Surely they win this round.
Kal-Hex almost goes down, stays alive for now, gets knocked back. The question is, do they come back onto the point? A Kraken's been picked up there by Yui. Kal-Hex will finally go down as well, which means, thankfully, for Dignity, they will manage to capture this first point, get on the payload, another 3 minutes to work with. Glad to see them being able to get across here and do so. And look, in the end, it wasn't so bad.
Oh, Render's very, very low. Jordation chasing quite aggressively, but he'll be getting back out of there. Kal-Hex has swapped off onto the Widowmaker. No more Pharah here. Render's still on the Pharah, though. I think that's a nice change up for Sydney Drop Bears. This is going to really cause some headaches for Dignity when they're flying around in the air. Although, actually, Render has swapped off onto Genji, so that's fair enough. Now the aggression out from the Drop Bears. Tanks, Shoyo, and Quats just diving in on their own.
Yep.
No real DPS to follow them up, although we do see Jordation just jumping in there toward the end. But the pick onto Dio, that's enough to keep Dignity stalled for the moment.
Yeah, well, not much work was really done, you could probably say, with the Hanzo, Jordan. So let's see.
Looks like we're diving.
Yeah.
For Dignity, Dio going onto the Lucio, so he's just going to try and boost his teammates right into the Drop Bears before Drop Bears can get too many kills, but it hasn't worked out too nicely at all.
No, not this time around. Potentially a great way to pick off the Widow as well, but Kal-Hex looking very comfortable here right now as the sniper. The payload, unfortunately for Dignity, just stopped here at what you would probably suggest is the very first choke point of Phase B.
No one can hide from my sight.
Infrasight up as well for Kal-Hex, which obviously makes life a little bit less enjoyable for Dignity, especially for those supports, which is who he's looking for right now. Not really going to be able to get too much out of this Infrasight, actually, but you could argue maybe it causes Dignity just to delay a little bit, buys a tiny bit of time,
yeah.
And Trans popped so early there from Dignity.
I think it does, to be fair. Buy the Drop Bears some time, and Burtlog going to be the first one going down to Yui as well. So a Kraken picked up. That's now no supports available here for the Drop Bears. Dignity getting the picks they need to get with this comp, Jordan. So we'll see how far they can get the payload through right now. Quats causing a bit of a ruckus though in the back line. Special Kid going to get found out there. And the payload, you can see just one hero on it right now. Make that none as it's contested here as well. But Minnie doing work, doing what she can. And maybe going to find Burtlock here in the meantime. That would be a great pick if they could get the Mercy two times in a row very, very quickly. But unfortunately for Dignity, that is not the case. And the Drop Bears holding strong at what is really not very far around the corner.
Yeah, they're barely able to push that payload forward at all. Quats did such a great job with Primal Rage to keep that payload from continuing to push forward, and it allowed the respawns for Drop Bears to come across. Dignity didn't really get anything done despite winning that fight there. Self-destruct is out, does nothing.
The dive's going to come back through, but the payload still is stopped, Jordan. Render ready with the Dragon Blade, just chasing down Kullhex. He's successful. Dragon Blade comes out, going to try and chase down the rest of the Drop Bears. Not going to happen. Quats coming through and cleaning the Genji up. Precisely what you want to see your Winston do when you hear that Dragon Blade go off. And Jordation as well, just here, uncontested right now. Will DMech Mini, the sound barrier going to come out from Lucio, but not going to come out in any decent sort of time frame, unfortunately, for Dignity. And it looks to me here, Jordan, like the Drop Bears will stop Dignity in their tracks. Phase B, 67 meters, that's all we'll see.
Yeah, really good value out of the Pulse Bomb that Jordation throws out there with the DMech and the kill onto Pisa. But all in all, I think that's another example of how the space created by the Sydney Drop Bears tanks is really, really paying dividends for their DPS players. You know, as soon as that Genji, or as soon as obviously Render there, throws out his Dragon Blade, we see him just absolutely decimated by the two tanks. And,
yeah.
You know, if you don't have to worry about a Genji that's Dragon Blading on top of you, as, for example, a Widowmaker, it makes life so much easier. You can just sit back there, take some pot shots, make life easy for yourself. And it really was quite easy for the Drop Bears there as well. I actually thought Dignity did a pretty good job to get that first point, because it really wasn't looking like they were going to be able to get it at all,
yeah,
was it?
And the time that they got it in wasn't even that bad, to be fair. It was just that their first three or four attempts were unimpressive.
Yeah.
In the end, the time, if they'd worked through that and got one tick on their second attempt, another tick on their third attempt, you'd say, hey, they're playing really well. It's just that their first few attempts didn't get any results at all. So in the end, they got it, and they pushed through into the second phase. But to be fair, Jordan, it's not a particularly defendable position here for Dignity.
No, not really. I think they're going to have to defend that first point, if anything. But from what we can see so far today, it really does look like Sydney Drop Bears are going to be able to quite easily clean up a 4-0, continue their perfect run this season, and continue to look for that 20-0, the elusive 20-0. I mean, Dignity, they looked okay last week. Pisa just coming into their roster as well. He seemed to slot in pretty nicely, but obviously, again, that was against Bin Chickens. And this is the Sydney Drop Bears. Two very, very different beasts.
Yeah, it is, right? You'd think Drop Bears probably feed on Bin Chickens.
Yep.
It's the circle of life.
Absolutely.
It's the circle of life. So Drop Bears out now on attack. They're going to be going Orisa Hog. They had both of those heroes on defense, but this time no D.Va. Instead, we'll be seeing Kullhex on the far out. Jordation over there. Two supports.
That's the point
straight
over.
Straight away, Jordation finds the kills. It just, man, look at that. Boom, that's three. Let's make it four. Done. Pizza is five.
He doesn't miss. He doesn't miss with those shots at all. I don't even think he missed a single shot there. Maybe the one on, maybe there was one onto Render, which he threw out that didn't connect. But apart from that, every single arrow that he fired connected, which is just incredible.
Look, it's. Let's be real. It is Mac who's played the game worthy, but
like, obviously
I just wasn't excited by it because.
Well, you see it every day, don't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, that's it. He keeps doing it. If I did that in one of my games, I'd be like, oh my god,
yep.
This is amazing.
Oh, well,
but it's Jordation, and he's like, yeah, easy.
He's not really going to buy any time, though.
Bertlog. Yeah, well, it's it.
The trouble
really
is the payload's not moving anyway. It's waiting for the gate to go up. So by the time Bertlog's back up, I mean, the payload starts moving now. So it's like they haven't lost any time there at all. Dragon Strike out straight away, of course,
Yui
from Jordation.
In a better position with the Dragon Strike of his own, has to wait for Kullhex to get out of his face. That would definitely be less than ideal, a deflected Dragon Strike coming back at you from your brother. But look, again, the Drop Bears pushing through. It's a 2-for-2 pick as Yo-Yo will find Pizza, and there you go. Easy does it. Yeah. The Drop Bears, obviously.
It's like a walk in the park, really, for them,
wasn't it? It was exactly like
just a casual
my
stroll.
Saturday afternoon in the Botanic Gardens, going for a stroll.
Yeah.
Just like that. It was pretty cruisy. To be fair, I didn't have to shoot anyone with arrows, but at the same time, it was, you know.
Maybe it would have been more fun if you did.
Let's not. So, It's 2-0. It's already at half time. We barely started, Jordan. Barely started.
This is the exact same storyline that we were talking about last week, where Drop Bears went up against Tainted Minds. Now they're doing the exact same thing to Dignity, where it's just not even close. This is a. It really looks like a formality at this point for the Drop Bears. Like, they're just kind of thinking, okay, can we get to the playoffs already, or can we get to the finals already? Because no one in Group A has even come close to us at all this season. And no one will come close to us at all this season.
I kind of felt bad there, by the way. I thought the melee was coming through for the kill. Actually goes to the D.Va. But yeah, look, let's be real. I think a lot of it, for whatever reason, you know, the Drop Bears just a little bit more mechanically skilled than the players or Dignity, obviously, playing as a team a little better. They're getting their picks that they want. You know, their target acquisition is on point. And even then, just knowing, like, they're not even, it's not even that they're finding it easy and then not taking it seriously. You know what I mean? Like, the plays that they're making are good plays.
Well, I actually do think,
looks easy.
I do think they're playing a little bit aggressive at times. Obviously, having a look at Jordation, he seems to be kind of just going with the flow, doing whatever he really wants to do. If they were up against a better opposition right now, I don't think they'd be playing quite this over-eager, looking for the kills quite that much. But they can absolutely get away with it, so why not at this point?
As you would. Good times if you're a Drop Bears fan, if you're Dignity. Look, still two maps to go, Jordan. Anything is possible.
Say that.
But I'd like to see it more like the first round we saw on Li Xiong Tower and not like everything else that we've seen today.
I think you may be going to be out of luck here, Ben, to be honest. Drop Bears not looking like they're going to be even coming close to dropping a map here today. So for me, it's a 4-0. Quite easy for the Drop Bears.
Well, it's half time between the Drop Bears and Dignity. The Drop Bears 2-0 up. There will be more Overwatch action right after the break.